Plagiarism is intellectual theft. It's using someone else's words or their ideas without giving proper citation. The most obvious example of that is if we fail to include quotation marks or some sort of citation that tells us where that material came from. There's a few different ways that students typically plagiarize. One way is that they completely take a different article, story, something someone else wrote, and they just change the name and turn it in as their own. That's definitely plagiarism, and very intentional. Another intentional way that students plagiarize is that they will take pieces of other articles, maybe from one article or maybe from multiple different articles or books, and they'll patch them together and maybe have a transition sentence or two in between, but it's mostly someone else's work. And again, that's obviously an example of plagiarism. There's other less obvious, sometimes unintentional ways that students plagiarize also. Sometimes a student will try to use a good resource, a book, an article, and they won't entirely put it in their own words. But that's because they think that the author did such a good job that they're trying to stick as close as they can to that author. They might change a word here or a word there, but it's still plagiarism. Another common form of plagiarism is when students fail to put a proper citation of some sort. They might put a wrong citation, and that's usually an accident, though it could be intentional if a student's trying to hide where their material came from. Sometimes students might get all of their material from one book, and they don't want it to be so obvious, so they change the footnotes to look like different books. That's also plagiarism.
So one of the things that I'm really stressing with my students today is anytime they use any type of outside source, whether it be a textbook, whether it be the internet, whether it be anything from Wikipedia to anything from Harvard University, they have to cite the source. And unfortunately, they believe if they're using something word for word, that's the only time they have to cite the source, which is absolutely incorrect. Anytime they use an image, anytime they use a figure, anytime they paraphrase anything from a source, they must cite the source.
I would define plagiarism as the use, or rather misuse, of someone else's ideas. When you have a thought, a statistic, a date, any bit of information that is not your information, and you put it in your paper, and you don't let someone else know that it is not your information, you've technically just plagiarized. All the ideas in the library, every book, every article, they're pretty much not your ideas, so anytime you act like they are your ideas, it's tantamount to theft. It's an intellectual theft, but it's a theft nonetheless. It would be like stealing someone's car, stealing someone's puppy, and you don't want to steal someone's puppy, so you don't want to steal their ideas, right? So anytime you have outside information, that's what you want to do. Always make sure you introduce your sources, cite your sources, and that's going to clear up plagiarism.